like to thank everybody for being out today as we honor and celebrate Josh's life. We're going to open in prayer. Father, we come before you today and ask you, Lord, to help us through these times. We cannot make it without you. The hard times and the questions we have in life, Lord, really bring us back to looking to you so many times. We ought to be doing that all the time, Lord, but when we forget, help us to look back to you in these times because we can't make it without you. Father God, we pray that you'd comfort every heart. You'd bless Brother Stevie with the words today. You'd let him go into the heart of every family member and every loved one, every friend, every contact that Josh has here today. And as they leave here and they go home and those memories hurt and those things begin to rise up, you let those words the preacher brings today bring comfort to each and every one. Because when we're gone from here and out alone, that's when the shock comes, that's when the hurt comes. But Lord, when those things are there, you said you'd be nigh unto a broken and contrite spirit. So we know when we're broken after these times, Lord, that you'll come nigh us, you'll come near us, Lord. We're depending on that. And this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Talk about old men. If you wonder how long Joshua Kent Eversole passed away Saturday, August 26, 2023, in Garrard County, Kentucky. Joshua was born in Richmond, Kentucky, to David Eversole and Shannon Hobbs on July 2nd, 1993. He was a carpenter by trade, was employed by JCL Home Improvements. He was preceded in death by his maternal grandparents, Cleo Hobbs and Betty Hobbs. Paternal grandmother, Joann Eversole, aunt, Sherry Whittemore, and uncle, Michael Hobbs. He is survived by his parents, David Eversole, Shannon Hobbs, and his second mom, Lynn Lear. Two children, Brayden Eversole and Brantley Eversole. The love of his wife, Haley Hickle. Siblings, Tabitha Texidor, Emma Eversole, Dusty Eversole, Jason Eversole, and Alex Eversole. Grandfather, Robert Eversole. Aunts, Kim Oliver, Vicky Turner, and Rhonda Browning. Nieces, Breelyn Perkins and Braxtyn Texidor. Cousins, Angela Snowden, Brooklyn Way, and Jacob Turner. His second family, Tyler Hickle, Kaycee Johnson, Cody Ledford, Gwyn Gerlaugh, and Thomas Hickle. Special friends, Kay and Chase Smitty, and his loving dog, Coco. I miss you, Josh. I wish it wasn't like this. I love you.
Somebody said from myself, has been so long living in hell. They say my lifestyle is bad for my health. It's the only thing that seems to help. All of this drinking and smoking is hopeless, but feel like it's all that I need. Something inside of me's broken. I hold on to anything that sets me free. I'm a lost cause. Baby, don't waste your time on me. I'm so damaged beyond. Life has shattered my hopes and my dreams. I'm a lost cause. Baby, don't waste your time on me. I'm so damaged beyond repair. Life has shattered my hopes and my dreams.
Missing the moon. There were no shooting stars to use wishing on you. And all of my sorrows, I just washed them down. It's the only peace I've ever found.
Smoking is hopeless, but feel like it's all that I need. Something inside of me's broken. I hold on to anything that sets me free. I'm a lost cause. Baby, don't waste your time on me. I'm so damaged beyond repair. Life is shattered, my hopes and my dreams.
says it's the end of time, and the Mississippi River, she's a-going dry. The interest is up and the stock market's down, and you're only getting mugged if you go downtown. I live back in the woods, you see, a woman and the kids and the dogs and me. I got a shotgun, a rifle, and a four-wheel drive, and a country boy can survive. Country folks can survive. I can plow a field all day long. I can catch catfish from dusk till dawn. Make our own whiskey and our own smoke too. Ain't too many things these old boys can't do. Boy can survive. Country folks can survive. Because you can't starve us out and you can't make us run. Those Whittemore boys raised on shotguns. We say grace and we say ma'am. If you ain't into that, we don't give a damn. We came from the West Virginia coal mines and the Rocky Mountains and the western skies. And we can skin a buck, we can run a trot line, and a country boy can survive. Country folks can survive. I had a good friend in New York City. He never called me by my name, just Hillbilly. My grandpa taught me how to live off the land, and his taught him to be a businessman. He used to send me pictures of the Broadway nights, and I'd send him some homemade wine. But he was killed by a man with a switchblade knife. For $43, my friend lost his life. I'd love to spit some beach nut in that dude's eyes and shoot him with my old 45, cause a country boy can survive. Country folks can survive. California and South Alabama and little towns all around this land. And we can skin a buck and run a trot line, and a country boy can survive. Country folks can survive.
Asked to sing this song is, I understand it's Josh's mama's favorite song, and I thought it'd be fitting for it to be played at some. I would like to say our goodbyes to Josh, and known him for a pretty long time, and didn't know him all that well until maybe the last this last chapter of his life, we'll just say, that long. He's been working with Cody, and we've got to be to know him a lot better. And I always knew him as a tough guy. Josh was a tough guy. And I could relate because I remember that stage and part of our life when it was so important to us to be tough. And I thought how in this last stage of his life, Josh was, he was working so hard to right wrongs of his past, working every Saturday, trying to get caught up on bills and pay off debts, and how much respect was growing from me in that, because I'm a man that believes in work and doing what's right and being a good citizen. Seeing him start to struggle, and different ones of us tried to help him. And come to church, if I'm not mistaken, July 30th, which was 1 month ago today. And I preached that night. And Josh and Haley were sitting on the pew. And when the preaching was over and I made the altar call, Josh just hung his head there at his seat. And I'm not the kind of preacher to put pressure on you, so we invited folks up to pray. And different ones came up. And I noticed Josh was looking at the floor, deep, deep contemplation. No doubt either talking to himself or talking to the Lord. And I put my hand on his shoulder, and he didn't look up at me. That's pretty typical in church, and sometimes church can take the tough guy out of you. And I said, sure, it would be good if you'd go up there and pray with us. And he just kind of gave me a side eye, and he said, yeah, it would. And I didn't continue to pressure him. That's just not my style. But somebody told me the other day, he told him he thought maybe I was upset with him because he didn't come pray, or mad at him, I believe is the word, because he didn't come pray that day. So I think maybe Mikey's mad at me because I didn't come up there and pray. I wasn't mad at him. I was heartbroken. Because as hard as he was working to right all his wrongs, you can never right all your wrongs. You can never fix your past. But you can let it go to a man named Jesus Christ that'll fix it. And he spent more time than he had to working so hard to do something that he couldn't do, that man Jesus can do in just a moment. He said, come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden. See, I didn't want Josh to leave church that night heavy laden anymore. He said, and I will give you rest. The people he said that to, they had to go back to work the next day. They had to go back to the fields and the farms and do the things they did. They had to carry the burdens of physical in this life. But when they lay their head down on the pillow, and when you lay your head down on the pillow after you've given Jesus those burdens, not the tough answer, doesn't seem to be anyway, but I can tell you now, I'm much tougher now than I was on the streets 20 years ago. And up and down the roads in the hollers, living the life. I told Stevie, this month made 19 years I'd been clean. Never been as tough as I am now. And I'll cry like a baby and call out upon that man that took my burdens. Some tough-looking guys in here today. It's probably not as tough as you think. You can't do it on your own. If you've got hurt and brokenness in the past and things that you're ashamed of, there's a man that can take it away in one prayer. I wasn't really scheduled to say anything, but Josh wasn't much of a rule follower, and I'm not real good at it either. Amen. I'm kind of home, sick for a country to which I've never been before. No sad goodbye.
time woman or anymore. Beulah land, I'm longing for you. And someday on thee I'll stand. There my home shall be eternal, Beulah land. Sweet Beulah land, I'm standing now looking out across that river where my faith is gonna end. There's just a few more weary days to labor, then I'm gonna take my heavenly flight. Beulah land, I'm longing for you, and someday on thee I'll stand. There my sweet Beulah land.
You know, I was thinking, and the way that it was laid out, that I was going to be doing the obituary and the message and the things like that. But you know, the Lord works things out in His way. You know, I was walking back through there and it kind of laid to my heart to ask this brother to do it, to read the obituary. I don't know him. I don't know who he is. But you know, I just come on back through here and then one of the ladies went back there. And guess who she got? Huh? Come on. And the song today, that song, Beulah Land, was laid on my heart this morning, and guess what? It come up. And you know, I thought today, as I was, there was many scriptures, many things goes through my mind, but I can remember Josh as a little boy, and him and my son and my stepson, they tore the hillsides up on them dirt bikes and motorcycles, and I'd say, boys, stay out of my driveway. Guess where they'd go, huh? Gravel, the hillsides, all of the riding and stuff and all of that, what we would give to go back to them days. And I'm sure at some point in their life, they at once upon a time, they probably told Josh and all them others, don't go around that boy's house. There ain't nothing but hoodlums there. Huh? Come on. Amen. You know, we done a lot of bad things on that hillside. But September the 13th of 1996, I'm coming up this month. It's coming month. I'm coming up on 27 years clean. Yeah. God's put in us a direction to try to reach the lost, to try to pull in the. I'm a jail minister. I'm a jail preacher, and I've preached a lot of funerals and things of people that got out of jail that just couldn't hold on to that right path. Amen. But I thought Josh pulled in my house one day and he got that motorcycle and he rolled up there and I heard something coming up the hill just making a noise, just barreling up through there. And all of a sudden he passed the house and he saw me out and he turned around and he come back and he was proud of that motorcycle.
Yeah.
Look what I'm doing. I'm doing good. I'm doing better. I'm making something of myself. You know. And he begins to talk, and I said, Josh, you got to watch other people out there on that motorcycle. You know, he said, I know that, you know, because he was pretty much born on a motorcycle, you know, riding, and they did all of that. But I thought if we could go back in time and we could just really do some things, what would we say? What memory would we have of Josh today? I thought about in the scripture that really stuck out into my mind. It says, let not, you know, in John chapter 14, it said, let not your heart be troubled. Now, in a situation like this, how do your heart not be troubled? But he goes further on to say, he said, ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. And he said, and I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, you may be also. And you know, I thought about in my days, in my time, people would tell me about the Lord. People would warn me, hey, yeah, you're going to have to. There's an old friend of mine, Dallas Adams. Amen. He said, that boy's either going to do one or two things. Told my mama, said he's either going to wind up in a graveyard or he's going to wind up in the penitentiary. Yeah. You know, and all of these things. But you know what? Amen. God had a plan in my life, just like each and every one of you's here. God's got a plan in our life.
Yeah.
You know, Josh, all of these people that's gathered today love Josh.
Yeah.
Huh? Amen.
Amen.
You know, they loved him. I thought his papa, Robert, over there, Josh got to where he wouldn't come out to the jail services. So you know what I did? I brought in Robert. Guess what Josh did? He came out.
Yeah.
Hey, man, I got a picture of him, you know, standing there hand in hand talking. You know, there's so many mixed emotions. If we could just go back, what would we do? What would we say? What would we, you know, I thought about just a few days ago that I was passing by y'all's house out there and I felt like stopping. But I didn't. I just kept driving. Huh? See, maybe, we can reach out to somebody. That's all my hope. You ever heard that song? All my hope is in Jesus.
Yeah.
Huh? And I thought about that song, that one song that they sang there a while ago. You know, it was all about. I circled that. Save me. Save me from what? Save me from myself. Save me from my addiction. Save me from my lost, mixed emotions. You know what? A lot of people turn to the drugs, to the alcohol, to the party lives, and all of this because they're hurting on the inside.
Yeah.
But if you'll just turn to Jesus, if you'll just let Jesus walk with you and talk with you, honey, let me tell you something. Hey, man, that's the best decision I ever made in my life. I've been in motorcycle wrecks, car wrecks, gunfights, barroom brawls, all of these crazy things out there. But God said, hey, come on now. And one day he just began to speak to my heart. It's now or never. I walked in to a drug rehab, amen, at Crossroads in London, Kentucky. Amen. Didn't know which direction I was, but I knew I had to have help.
Yeah.
I got to have help. And you know what God did? God saved me. Amen. He gave me hope. He gave me strength.
Yeah.
And I thought about the one scripture here in Psalms 37:25 said, I have been young and now I'm old. But I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor his seed a begging bread. You know what? This is sad, y'all. Amen. To see a little friend. Amen. I walked out of my back door, and I said, "Surely not. Surely not." You know, he's played on this hillside. Had a blast running. But you know what? Life, there's another scripture in James 4:14 said, "Whereas ye know not what shall be on tomorrow, for what is your life? It is even a vapor that appeareth for a little time and then vanishes away." Mm-hmm. Have you ever skipped a rock across the water and watched the riffles go and then they fade out? Yeah. Amen. Have you ever saw all of that stuff like that? It's coming. It's coming, a time in our life. I know Josh is gone, and I love Josh. I love to watch them boys play, him and my son, and Bo and them. Then he met Haley, you know, and they runned up and down them hills and went back to the lakes and camped out and all of them things out through there. He loved her. Yeah. He loved her. Amen. And, you know, I thought, praise God, today, amen, what would we give if we could talk to Josh today? What would we say to Josh today? But what the next thing that I would like to say, what would Josh say to you today? Listen today. Listen. Let give up. They sang a song sometime, "Give up and let Jesus take over. Let him have all your anxiety, your depression, amen, your stress. Everything, let him just begin to, hey man, pull your life over to him." Yeah. And don't give up. Don't give up. Don't look back. But Josh would say, "Listen, friends. Listen, mom, dad. Listen. Get a hold of Jesus." See, I'm not like this brother. I'll come after you to seek God. You know, come on, it's time's a wasting out. I've done a lot of jail people that has passed on, that's went on, and asked me to do their funerals. This is coming to everybody, y'all. I was praying, I was asking God, I was talking to God, I've been talking to God, I've been asking God what? He said, "Let not your heart be troubled." Honey, everybody's heart in here is troubled. My heart's troubled. When I walked out on that back porch and it just kind of hit me, David, that Josh is gone. Josh is gone. You know, it just seemed like a dream, don't it? Huh? But he's got two little young'uns coming up. You ever heard that old song, "Grandpa? Tell me about the good old days"? Huh? Tell me about it. Tell me about how my dad used to love to ride motorcycles and, hey, used to love to get out there and just be wild and free. But you know what? This right here, y'all, is coming to every one of us. But it's like a vapor. Life appears for a little while, and then it's going to vanish away. You know, we've got so much in God's hands. We got a ministry called Walking by Faith Recovery out at Cartersville Fellowship Hall. We've been running. There's a recovery group that comes every week pretty much. Amen. And recovery works. And I thought about one time we had like 90 of them in there. But you know, people's wanting help. People's coming to God. Don't turn him away tonight. If the Lord is dealing with your heart today, don't turn him away. Don't do as I did and turned him away a many a times. And I walk around now, my legs fall apart and my whole body's falling apart and I can't hardly get out of bed of a morning from the motorcycle wrecks, the car wrecks, and playing with the devil. You know, we used to headbang to that one group called ACDC. You know, I was on a highway to hell, and we thought, boy, we rocking into that. But if you ever listen to the lyrics to something like that, amen, turn your life around. Don't give up. Walk to Jesus. Walk to Jesus. Amen. Talk with Jesus. Do what, amen, this good book right here tells us. Follow me and I'll make you fishermen of men.
Yeah.
You know, I would always, Josh, when he was at the jail, I'd get after him, get after him. You know, trying my best, just like I do my own children. Please, today, I know your hearts is grieved over Josh. And as I can, you know, I know David and Sharon, their hearts are grieved. And everybody's hearts is all grieved over us. And there's going to come a day that you're going to think about him. You're going to cry about him. You're going to laugh at what he did, what he said, the times you've had, the times you spent together. But listen, don't let this be the end. If you feel like if there's no hope for you, come out on Thursday nights. Amen. We'll love you, man. Huh? Amen. We'll try to help you the best that we can. But God only knows what's in our hearts, what's on our minds. See, a lot of you in here are dealing with different issues up here in this old head. But you know what it does? A lot of times up here, it'll shoot poison down to here. And I see that a lot. I see that a lot. I've been in jail ministry for 24 years. And I've seen them come and I've seen them go. But I wish that I could get one more opportunity with Josh. But his race is run. He's fought the fight of, but you know what? He's in the hands of a just God. He's in that hands of a just God. And you and I got to realize right tonight, you've got an opportunity. This is my opportunity to tell you that if you walk away from God and you walk out into this world, amen. You ever heard that old song? There's a heaven to gain. That's what I want. I want them place. Because once upon a time, I thought that I could just do anything I wanted. And you know what? What gets me a lot is Josh saw me when I was in that wild stage. He saw that home. He saw them crazy people up there on that hillside doing crazy things and doing things. And just maybe, he might have wanted to pattern himself after some of them. That's why that I fight so hard. That's why I'm fighting so hard. Because I probably led so many people in that direction with the wild side and everybody living that. But try to pull them and come on. While there's still time to make up your mind, come on. And I know today that you say, but Brother Steve, this is a funeral, and I know it is. I know Josh is. Josh would tell you, hey, man, we ain't none of us, amen, ever crossed over yet, but Josh has crossed over. And you and I have got to realize, while there's still breath in your body, make up your mind today. And if you say, Brother Steve, I just can't do it. That's what I thought. I was a sound man for Josh Logan, played the Maverick Club, done all of these things, rode motorcycles, done a lot of crazy. I didn't want to give up the world. I didn't want to give all that stuff up. Till one day, I got that knock on my heart. He said, it's now or never. And I turned my life and my will over to the Lord. Was it easy? I wished I'd done it a long time ago. And today, as we get ready to dismiss in this service, and we're going with our last ride with Josh, I just thought how the Lord worked this service out the way that he did. But my friends, they're singing a song. Can I sing just a little bit of it? Said, my friend, if the Lord should speak unto you, if he beckons you, please let the Savior in. 'Cause this might be the only time he'll call you. So don't take the chance, 'cause this chance could be the end. Amen. As we close in this service today, I want you to bow your heads for a moment. And this little poem I've said a lot. Lord, would you walk with this family today? Lord, would you give them strength throughout these weeks and these months and these years to come? And Lord, we ask you, God, to direct them in the right direction. And God, I know their hearts are so troubled and so burdened down. But Lord, let them think of the good things that Josh had did, Lord God. The good things that Josh had say. And Lord, tell his children he was a good man. He was a good young man. Lord, and we ask this to be done in Jesus' name today, and let us all say, amen, amen.
You all appreciate it. When I was younger and my mama had beef, 17 years old, kicked out on the streets. Though back at the time, I never thought I'd see a face. Ain't a woman alive that could take my mama's place. Suspended from school, I'm scared to go home. I was a fool with the big boys breaking all the rules. Shed tears with my baby sister. Over the years, we was poor than other little kids. And even though we had different daddies, the same drama when things went wrong, we blamed mama. I reminisce on the stress I caused. It was hell, hugging on my mama from a jail cell. In elementary, hey, I see the penitentiary one day, running from the police, that's right. Mama catch me, put a whooping to my backside. And even as a crack fiend, mama, you always was a black queen, mama. I finally understand, for a woman it ain't easy trying to raise a man. You always was committed, a poor single mother on welfare. Tell me how you did it, there's no way I can pay you back. But the plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
Baby, don't you know we love you, sweet
dear mama.
Baby, place no one above you, sweet.
You all appreciate it.
Baby, don't you know we love you.
Now ain't nobody tell us it was fair. No love for my daddy, 'cause the coward wasn't there. He passed away and I didn't cry, 'cause my anger wouldn't let me feel for a stranger. They say I'm wrong and I'm heartless, but all along I was looking for a father, he was gone. I hung around with the thugs, and even though they sold drugs, they showed a young brother love. I moved out and started really hanging. I needed money of my own, so I started slanging. I ain't guilty, 'cause even though I sell rocks, it feels good putting money in your mailbox. I love paying rent when the rent's due. I hope you got the diamond necklace that I sent to you. 'Cause when I was low, you was there for me. You never left me alone because you cared for me. And I can see you coming home after work late. You're in the kitchen trying to fix us a hot plate. You're just working with the scraps you was given. And mama made miracles every Thanksgiving. But now the road got rough, you're alone. You're trying to raise two bad kids on your own. And there's no way I can pay you back. But my plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
Baby, don't you know we love you, sweet.
And dear mama,
place no one above you, sweet.
You all appreciate it.
Baby, don't you know we love you.
Pour out some liquor and I reminisce, 'cause through the drama I can always depend on my mama. And when it seems that I'm hopeless, you say the words that can get me back in focus. When I was sick as a little kid, to keep me happy, there's no limit to the things you did. And all my childhood memories are full of all the sweet things you did for me. And even though I act crazy, I gotta thank the Lord that you made me. There are no words that can express how I feel. You never kept a secret, always stayed real. And I appreciate how you raised me, and all the extra love that you gave me. I wish I could take the pain away. If you can make it through the night, there's a brighter day. Everything will be alright if you hold on. It's a struggle every day, gotta roll on.
There's no way I could pay you back, but my plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
Don't you know enough is sweet,
dear mama.
Place no one above me, sweet.
You all appreciate it.
Don't you know enough is sweet,
dear mama.